Hey guys, it's Gizmo Joe. I'm back with a quick review on an Air Mouse. Just before I start the video, I want to apologize for the video quality or sound quality. I'm still in the United States, so I don't have access to any of my normal video recording stuff. So I'm just doing this on an old phone. So hopefully this turns out okay. But what I have with me today is the TZ MX3 2.4 gigahertz Air Mouse. So I've done a review on an Air Mouse before, and I quite like them. As far as this guy, I got him because he was on sale, essentially to replace this thing. So this is the Logitech K400R. Essentially, it's a full keyboard with a little mouse pad over here, so it's really, really good for operating like little Kodi boxes and stuff like that, which is what I have here in the States. But it's big, and it doesn't light up. So when I'm watching stuff at night, it can be a pain to use because I can't really see what I'm doing because I like to have the lights off, you know, climb in bed, that sort of thing. And I can't really see what I'm doing, and it's bulky, and it slides off, and it hits the ground, and so I wanted something a little smaller, and preferably something with a backlight. So, I had a look on GearBest.com, and what I found was this guy. This guy here was on sale, so I think it was only about $9. I'll put a link down in the description if you want to purchase this one. But one of the things that drew me to it was the fact that on the flip side, it's got a keyboard. Now, this isn't a full QWERTY keyboard. I don't know if you can see that, but it's about, there's a couple of buttons missing, but you have essentially the whole alphabet, which is all you really need, and an enter button, which is fine for me. Now, I will say, this is obviously the box. There's nothing special really about this guy. I will say that the English, whoever wrote it, is pretty good. It did come with a little manual, which is right here. It actually is helpful. It is in English. I could understand it. It made sense. So that's a plus, but not necessarily a deal breaker because this sort of stuff isn't really hard to figure out anyway. So this guy here actually operates on two AAA batteries, and I find the battery compartment really difficult to get off, but there they are in there. Got some Kirklands from Costco, so that's always good. I would have preferred a Air Mouse that actually had rechargeable batteries, but for the price, I couldn't pass this one up. So first thing I thought was that it was pretty thick, but it actually isn't, you know, feels pretty good to hold in the hand. Now, the buttons are all a silicone material, so they're nice and soft to the touch. They feel pretty good. The body is just plastic, and like I said, there's not much to it. It's just basically a bar shape. It's not ergonomic or anything like that, but like I said, it's not difficult to hold or uncomfortable to hold or whatever. Anyway, the buttons feel really nice. They're all very responsive. You have volume buttons. Everything just worked. It comes with like one of those little dongles. I plugged it straight into my Android TV stick that I have here in the States, and it just worked fine straight off the bat. Now, you can see down here it's got one of these little mouse buttons. If I click that, that makes a cursor appear on the screen, and it operates as an Air Mouse, so I can move it around and click on things, and it works perfectly, 100%, no problems. So I was very happy with that. You may need to configure the mouse function in your device if you do get this. I found that mine was a little off, but I just went into the settings and played around with the cursor settings, and everything was sweet after that. The keyboard works well. I find that, you know, you do need to hold it with two hands. That's okay. And again, it's not a QWERTY layout. It is, but it's not. So, I mean, if you're a touch typist and you think you know where the buttons are, because you're missing a few buttons, that you might make some mistakes, but I didn't really have an issue with it. But one of the other really interesting things about this guy is that the keys do light up. Now, it's probably hard to tell because you can't really see because the lighting in this room is pretty good. But if I click that little button there, it looks like a little light bulb, but I don't get to see that. If I click that, it makes the buttons illuminate, which, again, super handy for when you're, you know, watching TV at night or whatever, you have the lights off, etc. So again, you click that little button there and it lights these guys up. Just it's not super bright where it's blinding or anything or it's going to distract you. It's just enough. But what I found was really cool about this guy is that when I click that button and I flip the remote over, the backlight turns on this side but shuts off on this side. and vice versa. So when I have that button clicked in, when I flip it over, that's the side that is illuminated, which I thought was a really nice touch, because basically it means that it's cutting down on all the ambient light. So if you are watching at night, it's not going to be super bright at the bottom when you're holding this thing. It's only going to be lit up on the side that you're using, which I thought was a really, really nice touch. But that's pretty much it. Other than that, it's an Air Mouse. It functions. The buttons do what they say they do. And, you know, configuring it was super easy. Again, the mouse had to be configured a little bit on my end. But other than that, everything works straight out of the box. No issues whatsoever. And I'm really, really happy with that backlight function. I think it's really cool that it can sense what side I have flipped over and illuminate accordingly. So again, apologies for the video quality. Again, I'm still in the States, so I'm working with a fairly limited sort of hardware options available to me. But I will be back in Australia in about 2 weeks, so hopefully my video quality will improve once I get back. But expect some more videos before then. And again, thanks for tuning in. Subscribe, like, comment, whatever. It's always great to hear feedback. But until next time, I'll see you guys later. This is Gizmo Joe signing off.